by a lucky coincidence, ride-hailing businesses are showing a steady growth all over the world, and they're expected to go on with this for the next couple of decades. Despite the pandemic, unequal economic development of regions, high-level market saturation, and despite the fact that Uber and other dominating players, there is still huge room to grow. We expect the market size to grow by $213 billion by 2025. People will be making use of multiple ride-hailing apps. It's on the way to becoming a mainstream service among consumers from nearly all walks of life. More consumers are interested in ride-hailing than have so far adopted it, indicating significant near-term growth potential. There are a lot of mature taxi business guys: Uber, Careem, Lyft, Gett, Grab, Bolt, Didi, Gojek, Cabify. Is there a space for new players, and what are the successful strategies? There's hardly a country that doesn't yet have any kind of ride-hailing company working there. Places with zero competition are often not the places where you want to start a business in the first place. Think of North Korea. Two strategies help smaller players build a profitable ride-hailing business if the competition is high. Focus on a niche market segment that are typically underserved by bigger operators. Focus on specific regions, cities, to limit competition with bigger players and drive down the incentives and marketing expenses. Ola, the ride-hailing leader in India. Even Uber, with this disruptive approach, didn't manage to beat them. The major part of the success was that Ola provides a unique, though very popular service in India, the three-wheeler, also known as the auto rickshaw. Another clever move by Ola was to allow customers to pay cash, a feature that was lacking in the Uber platform for 2 years after entering the Indian ride-hailing service market. Another great example is Hop Skip Drive. This company has launched an Uber for kids in Los Angeles. What customers needed was a reliable business to drive their kids to school and back every day in a crowded city. Hop Skip Drive jumped right at the possibility and launched a service for people to pre-order rides with drivers who passed a thorough background check and met the parents in real life. Result? Parents happy, kids safe. Hop Skip Drive has a nice market share and a $10 million investment. And it's planning to scale up with services for various social groups. Smaller taxi businesses can choose to focus on smaller regions or cities, typically underserved by bigger players, and limit their competitive play only to such areas. This will create room for smaller taxi businesses to cut sales and marketing expenses. Instead of launching in Riyadh, the capital of Saudi Arabia, owned by Careem, our partner Kayan launched in small cities first, grew there, and then scaled up to the capital eventually. It helped Kayan become one of the leaders in the whole of the Saudi Arabian market. This is an example of smart geo-segmentation. Uber could easily launch a ride-hailing option for kids or start working in smaller cities, but that's just not a priority for them. So, offer what they can't, because it's against their core business model. For example, women-only driver service, partnership with airports, hotels, restaurants, and shopping malls, zero-emission vehicles, VIP service, pet-friendly, or pre-booked rides. Such providers as Yulendo in Zambia, Ride in Ethiopia, have become local ride-hailing leaders. They have changed the transportation infrastructure of their countries. So if you're looking for ways to improve transportation in your community, interested in a sustainable business idea that you want to realize, think hard about a viable startup model. The ride-hailing industry might very well be what you're looking for. Becoming a local alternative to Uber is still an attractive and profitable business idea for many daring startups, especially in places with high traffic congestion. Underdeveloped public transportation systems and growing urbanization tendencies are the perfect spots for ride-hailing businesses to flourish. Launching an innovative mobility app means more than just finding a suitable software stack. It means looking for unorthodox solutions, emission-free vehicles, active participation in the life of the local community, teaming up with unconventional business partners. Are you one of them? Then join a community of daring entrepreneurs that are making people's lives better. Share your cool business cases in the comments. Sign up to our channel to get more business insights. And don't be shy to follow us on social media. We look forward to hearing from you. Together, let's rock the market. We'll be right back.